Good morning, second grade, and happy Wednesday. I hope everyone is ready for today and they're going to get all their work done and they're excited. Today we have our Zoom call. Remember, I sent you guys instructions on how to get on our call onto your Edsby. So it's at 5 o'clock tonight. Don't forget. So I want you guys to, if you haven't already and you haven't been on a call yet, you just download the app on your phone or on a tablet or on a parent's phone or on a computer, and then when it's time to join the call, you can either click the link on Edsby, or I put a little meeting code and password in the message I sent you on Edsby, and you just set join, and then you just type in the meeting code, and then it asks you for the password, and then you type in the password, and then you'll be able to see all your friends' faces, and it'll be so much fun. I'm excited. So if you haven't come yet to any of our meetings, make sure you join us tonight, okay? So today, what I want you guys to do is you have a you're going to read Introducing Africa. In that book, you're going to read pages 12 through 15, and you're learning about weather and I think animals today. All right, so I want you guys to focus and make sure you're reading our headings, right? And then looking at our keywords and our captions. Remember, our captions explain what's going on in our picture. Some of these photographs are things that we've never seen before, so we have to make sure we read our captions so we can learn a little bit better, right? All right, so I've been reading Because of Winn-Dixie to you guys. So I'm going to go ahead and read the next chapter to you guys now. Hopefully Opal gives Winn-Dixie a bath, because remember, he was not smelling very nice. I started in on Winn-Dixie right away, trying to clean him up. First, I gave him a bath. I used the garden hose and some baby shampoo. He stood still for it, but I could tell he didn't like it. He looked insulted the whole time, and he didn't show me his teeth or wag his tail once. After he was washed and dried, I brushed him real good. I used my own hairbrush and worked real hard at all the knots and the patches of fur stuck together. He didn't mind being brushed. He wiggled his back. It probably felt pretty good. The whole time I was working on him, I was talking to him, and he listened. "See," I said, "you don't have any family, and neither do I. I've got the preacher, of course, but I don't have a mama. I mean, I have one, but I don't know where she is. She left when I was 3 years old. I can't hardly remember her. And I bet you don't know remember your mama either. So it's almost like we're orphans." Winn-Dixie looked straight at me when I said that to him, like he was feeling relieved to finally have someone understand his situation. I nodded my head at him, and I went on talking. "I don't even have any friends because I had to leave them all behind when we moved here from Whatley. Whatley's up in North Florida. Have you ever been to North Florida?" Winn-Dixie looked at the ground like he was trying very hard to remember. "You know what?" I said. "Ever since we moved here, I've been thinking about my mama extra hard, more than ever when I ever did at Whatley." Winn-Dixie's eyes twitched in his ears, and he raised his eyebrows. "I think the preacher thinks about mama all the time, too. He's still in love with her. I know that because I heard the ladies at church in Whatley talking about him. They said he's still hoping she'll come back. But he doesn't tell me that. He won't talk to me about her. I want to know more about her, but I'm afraid to ask the preacher. I'm afraid he'll get mad at me." Winn-Dixie looked hard, like he was trying to say something. "What?" He stared at me. "You think I should ask the preacher about my mama?" Winn-Dixie looked at me so hard that he sneezed. "I'll think about it," I said to him. When I was done working on him, Winn-Dixie looked a whole lot better. He still had his bald spot and his fur that didn't clean up very nice. And I couldn't do anything about his crooked yellow teeth because he got into a sneezing fit every time I started to brush them with my toothbrush, and I finally had to give up. But for the most part, he looked a whole lot better, and I took him into the trailer and showed him to the preacher. "Daddy," I said. "Hmm." He was working on a sermon and kind of muttering to himself. "Daddy, I wanted to show you the new Winn-Dixie." The preacher put down his pencil, rubbed his nose, and then finally he looked up. "Well," he said, smiling real big at Winn-Dixie. "Well, now, don't you look handsome?" Winn-Dixie smiled back at the preacher, and he went over and he put his head in the preacher's lap. "He smells nice, too," said the preacher. He rubbed Winn-Dixie's head, and he looked into his eyes. "Daddy," I said real quick before I lost any of my nerves. "I've been talking to Winn-Dixie." "Is that right?" the preacher said. "I've been talking to him, and he agreed with me that since I'm 10 years old, you should tell me 10 things about my mama. Just 10 things, that's it." The preacher stopped rubbing Winn-Dixie's head and held real still. "One thing for each year I've been alive," I told him. "Please." Winn-Dixie looked up at the preacher and kind of gave him a nudge with his nose. The preacher sighed, and he said to Winn-Dixie, "I should have guessed you were going to be trouble." Then he looked at me. "Come on, Opal," he said. "Sit down, and I'll tell you 10 things about your mama." So we will read our 10 things about Opal's mom tomorrow. All right. And I hope that I see you guys tonight on Zoom. Make sure if you guys need help, remember, just message me on Edsby. Okay. Or you can have your parents send me a text message and I can help explain it to them on how to get on Zoom so you guys can see some of your friends tonight. I hope to see you then. Okay. Bye.